The project management discipline still has to further improve its performance after 60 years of existence, despite the many great examples that have been delivered. That's the story that we are repeating over and over again as researchers in the field of project management. It was Brigadier General Bernard Schiever who coined the term project management for the first time in 1957. Since then, the track record of project management has been far from great. Admittedly, if we make such a blunt statement, we first have to identify what project success actually entails. It's not the same for all involved. Success is clearly a subjective measure. It varies over time. It varies by project type. So how to define success in such a way that we can all use it to our advantage? Since the views on success can be so different, it's best to agree upfront what the success criteria will be. In an early stage of the project, during the opportunity framing, three questions will have to be answered by the joint and integrated project team. What will we deliver? How will success be judged? And who has a say in answering the first two? The biggest advantage of this approach is that it guides the scope of the project, what it is and what it's not. It maximizes the chance of success and it gets people aligned towards a common goal. Look at opportunities outside your direct influence. By agreeing the success criteria, a common goal has been identified. By subsequently focusing on and agreeing the success factors, the means to achieve that goal will be identified. Traditionally, the project management standards will have identified the required activities and processes that have to be executed to deliver the project. For instance, the Project Management Body of Knowledge, or PMBOK for short, has identified 11 knowledge areas with related activities that are required for delivering a project. But unfortunately, just applying these activities is not a sufficient requirement for successful completion. Projects might still fail despite executing all those activities. What are the causes of these failures? Many volumes of project management literature have been filled with these causes. To name a few, underestimation of the cost due to lack of experience, deliberately underestimating the cost to win the contract, unclear and incomplete specifications, changing the scope during execution because of a lack of sufficient interaction in previous phases, over-optimistic in implementing novel technology, the firing of unforeseen risk, inflation and over-optimistic project leader or unrealistic management. We can extend this list for a while. One reason that is surfacing nowadays more and more is the increased complexity of contemporary projects. Sometimes used as an excuse, but quite often a real and emerging issue. And even if this increased complexity is recognized, the consequences are largely underestimated. This brings us then to the subject of this course on mastering project complexity. What is the complexity that we are facing in current projects? How is complexity described from a more theoretical perspective? It is difficult to find an unambiguous definition of complexity in literature. Baccherini, as one of the first, defines project complexity as consisting of many varied and interrelated parts. To operationalize this, he broke complexity down into the number of varied elements and the interdependencies between these different elements. Later on, Williams went a step further and distinguished structural complexity and uncertainty as constituting elements of complexity. These main elements of complexity, structural complexity and uncertainty, are also recognized in the model of Hertog and Westerveld. They distinguish detail complexity and dynamic complexity. Detail complexity is characterized by a high number of components with a high degree of interrelatedness, and dynamic complexity is characterized by the potential to evolve over time and the limited understanding and predictability. Detail complexity is knowable, and project management managers are often able to handle this. Dynamic complexity has uncertainties. Project managers cannot predict for certain the outcome of their actions. These are just a few examples of complexity models that have emerged over the years, enabling project managers to identify the complexity and think about responses to deal with the emerging complexity. Maybe stating the obvious, but complexity is not necessarily necessarily related to large capital costs or the size of the project. A relatively low-cost project can be very complex, whereas in some instances, a high-cost project can be simple. Complexity is not only about size, it is the increasing number of interfaces and their dynamic character over time that makes a project complex. In the research at TU Delft, we found that project complexity can be subdivided in three distinct areas: technical complexity, organizational complexity, and external complexity. This classification has been developed based upon a thorough literature review and detailed investigation of a large number of projects in both the process and the construction industry. Technical complexity is the traditional view of project managers and engineers and mainly focuses on the content. The softer and behavioral view is covered by the organizational complexity and the broader external view of stakeholders, the environment of the project, and sometimes the politics is covered by external complexity. The purpose of the models is to support the identification of the elements that contribute to the increased complexity of projects. Once again, the aim of using such models is not to reduce the complexity, because that will be almost impossible, but to become more aware of the contributing factors and adapt the style and approach of managing the project to the perceived complexity. So we are not trying to reduce or remove the complexity, but we are identifying ways of coping with the complexity. Reducing the complexity is considered almost impossible due to the fact that the complexity is highly subjective and highly dynamic. So reducing the complexity in one instance might generate additional complexity in the next instance. So learning to cope is probably much more effective. Or even increasing complexity can be beneficial, such as adding a functionality to create broader support. In this way, the project manager is able to prepare and commit rather than to predict and control.